Hello there and welcome to today's tutorial in which I'll be showing you how to make a custom wedding cake topper with polymer clay. Today I'll be making a traditional bride and groom wedding cake topper, but of course they can be made for couples of all and every gender, so basically it's just really to use my models as a template to get creative in making your own. This is quite an in-depth class actually, and I say class because it was originally made for Skillshare, so it really does go into quite some depth, so I would recommend that you watch the entire video before you start work on your wedding cake topper, really because I share loads of tricks and tips along the way, so I'm sure you'll find a lot of it quite useful. This video is a real labour of love, as I'm sure you'll appreciate as you go through it, and I just wanted to mention, and I rarely do this with my videos, if you do watch the video and you do get some value out of it and you go on to make your own wedding cake topper, I would really appreciate it if you could maybe consider donating to my Ko-fi, or Ko-fi, however you pronounce it, and I'll leave that linked below. If you're not in a position to do so, I would really appreciate it if you could instead leave a like and a comment down below on this video, as it helps the YouTube algorithm gods push it out to further people really, so it all helps in terms of supporting my channel. So without further ado, let's get started. So for this class I'll be using Femo Professional polymer clay, as I use it for most of my project work, and I personally say it's the best for making models or cake toppers. So I'll be using quite a lot of white for the dress and the base, grey, black, pink, green and skin tones, and I will talk some more about skin tones during this class, and I'll also be using some old spare clay. In terms of tools, I'll be using these here, and I'll also leave a list of the tools that I use in class description. But to summarise, I've got a large cookie cutter in 98mm, some sturdy craft wire, some scissors, my scalpel, some ball tools, my needle tool, a blade cutting tool, and my acrylic roller. I'll also be using a teeny tiny leaf shape tool, and you can add some seed beads to your dress as well. I find that wet wipes are an essential tool for a polymer clay artist, and I'll be going through quite a few in this class. And I'll also be using some Sculpey clay softener and some liquid Femo. And last but not least, I'll be using my pasta machine, which helps both to condition the clay and to ensure that you've got some nice flat clay to work with, particularly for the wedding dress. Before you move on to making your wedding cake topper, I thought I'd share some tips with you first. And tip number one is, if you can, to make a wedding cake topper out of some old clay first. I'm fully aware that this can be quite a tricky project at times, particularly when you're incorporating quite some detail. So if you're able to and you do have some old clay to hand, I'd suggest that you just try and play with that first of all, really to try and get an idea of what your wedding cake topper's going to look like before you start using some really clean and pristine white clay basically. You could also, if you like, try and use some plasticine, really so that you try and get an idea of how the form will come together before you start working with polymer clay. Tip number two, and this is for those that are going to be working on a traditional white dress for the brides. I would suggest having a whole block of the white clay around, because I'm just fully aware that the cleaner your results will look at the ends, the better it will be really, particularly if it's going to be displayed on an actual wedding cake. You want your work to look pristine really, so I found that white clay particularly has a knack of picking up, you know, airborne fibres or tiny bits of debris that are kicking around, and no matter how many wet wipes you use, can be tricky to try and keep your clay clean. So I find if the white clay that you're using is, you know, just really quite dirty, I would suggest that you start again on it, in all honesty, but you know, that's entirely up to you, but yeah, I'd suggest having a whole block kicking around if you're working with a Femo professional. And don't worry, your white clay won't get wasted if you find that you have to start again. because I would suggest that you have a bag of old clay kicking around for project work that's, you know, you don't actually see on the end result, such as in this class, actually. You know, I use some old clay for under the skirts and for the groom's body. So yeah, keep a bag of old clay kicking around for project work because you will use it. Tip number three is take your time. I found in the past that a wedding cake topper can take anywhere up to a week to make. And I'd really recommend that you take regular breaks as well, just to keep you kind of focused on your work, really, to ensure that it's nice and neat at the end. For tip number four, this is a useful one for when you're trying to keep your work nice and clean. And also when you're working on larger projects, when you're working in stages, basically, such as this one, is to cover your work when you're not working on it. White clay has a knack for picking up any tiny bits of airborne fibres, etc. So what I tend to do is to use a food bag, and that's a large food bag on top of my work, just, you know, to keep it in the corner away from everything else, and it will keep it sort of dust free, hopefully. And I'm going to move on to another tip now, and that's how to get prepared for your projects. As with any larger scale polymer clay projects, I think it's always worth investing some of your time into really planning ahead and sketching out what you want your project to look like, as I think the more time you invest into this process, the more successful your end result will be. And it will also allow you the opportunity to really think about what colours you'll need for your polymer clay projects. And to start the projects, I need to make the base for my topper, so I'm just going to condition some clay with my pasta machine here. And polymer clay, and particularly white polymer clay, has a knack of picking up tiny airborne fibres, so with my blaze cutting tool here, I'm just going to cut out any that I see, basically. And I'll try and flatten this a little with my hands before starting with my acrylic roller to flatten the clay. And I'd really advise working with parchment paper with any polymer clay project, basically, because firstly, it will allow you to keep your clay nice and clean because you're not having to move it around with your fingers. But also it will ensure that you're not putting any unnecessary indentations onto your clay work as well. And I've got my largest cookie cutter here, and that's 98mm. And of course, you can create any shape for your base that you like, really, but I'm going to go round. And I'll just pop that out, like so. So I'm just going to do my final clean with a wet wipe. And there is a slight ding in my base here, but I'm not too concerned about that because I'm basically going to hide it with my bride's skirts. So now I'm going to move on to making the groom's shoes. So I've got two balls of black polymer clay here, and they're of exactly the same size. So I basically just need to make a very basic shoe shape, like so. And it's almost reminiscent of a wine gum sweets here in the UK. And they look of a similar size, which is good. So I want to add just a little bit of detail to the shoe, but you don't have to do this. But I'm using my needle tool basically to make a little indentation, like so. And I'll do the same on the other. And just place that onto the base. And in terms of placements, I've got an old wedding cake topper here that you'll see. It's a little bit dusty, but it's just to give you an idea about placements, really. So you need to take up basically almost half of the base for your groom, or for each person, really. So yep, hopefully that gives you an idea of where your shoes should be going. So I'm moving on to the trousers now, but just as a little tip, I'd recommend that you have lots of clay in the same colour, because you'll be making the suit and the waistcoat as well a little later on. So you might well want to use a colour straight out of the packet, so you know once you return to it, it's exactly the same colour. But if you're using a bespoke colour, just make sure you've got enough. So I'm just going to roll out a length of the grey clay, like so. And with my blaze cutting tool, I'm just going to take the ends off. And then I'll just curve the clay over. And to attach the trousers to the shoes, I've just got a length of craft wire here. And it doesn't matter too much about the size or gauge of the craft wire, just as long as it's pretty sturdy. And you could actually use cocktail sticks. So I've got some liquid Fimo here, so I'll just add a little dollop, and I use it really because it helps to make your pieces stick together basically during baking. So now I can just try and ease the trousers on, like so. And it just takes a little bit of time to ensure that you're headed in the right direction basically. And once they're added on, I'm just going to pop in some more craft wire at the top. So I'll add two pieces. And again, I'll add on some liquid Fimo just to help the wire basically stick to the clay during baking. So I'm going to move on to the bride's body now. Well, the base of it anyway. And I've got some old pieces of clay here. And I basically just need to make a little kind of lump, really. Like so. So I just need to just try and condition that a little. And once I'm happy with that, I'm just going to pop in two pieces again of the craft wire. And just really trying to force that in. I just press down on my surface really to try and get it to go all the way through. And again, some of my liquid Fimo. And then I can just try and plot out where I want that to go. And hopefully this is going to go over the ding that's in my base as well. So there we go, just push that down. And I'll add in some craft wire again. And I'll just pop in the seconds. And some more liquid Fimo. I think I need to get another bottle of this now. And I'll just spend a little bit of time just working that into a very loose skirt shape or underskirt shape. So now it's time to bake our base. So I've just popped my base on a baking sheet that I use only for polymer clay work, as you shouldn't be using tools that you use for clay with food as well. And I've got an old mug here as well, again just for polymer clay work, and I'm using it just to prop up the trousers in case they decide to fall during baking, but hopefully that won't be the case. And I've got just a little bit of parchment paper between the two as well, so it doesn't stick. So this is now off to the oven. And at this point, you'll need to refer to your own brand of polymer clay's baking instructions. So now we're going to move on to make the bride's body and dress. And I just wanted to mention that in terms of skin tones, I use the Doll Art collection from Fimo, and I tend to buy Cameo, Sands and Nougat or Nuggets. Skin tones are of course all on a spectrum, so I find these to be pretty good to work with, and of course they can all be blended together as well to get the skin tone that you're after. So I'm just going to start by building up some clay on the upper body of the bride. So I'm just basically going to wrap some clay around the wire parts, like so. and I'll just gradually build up on that. And you'll need to bear in mind that you'll need quite a prominent neck area, so I'm just bearing that in mind as I go. And I really need to blend in the polymer clay onto the base at the bottom here, so that hopefully no bulges will appear through your dress once it's on. And I'll pop through some craft wire into the neck area. And then really try and mould the polymer clay around the neck. And I'll just use a wet wipe to really try and get that clay to blend together. So that's all looking pretty good, but I need my form to look a lot more female, so I'll just add on some dots of clay to add on some boobs, basically. And I'll just use my medium-sized ball tool here to really try and blend those pieces together. And I'll use a wet wipe as well to really try and get those pieces to stick together, really. So that's looking a lot more like a female form now, so I can move on to her dress. So I'm making the dress with the white polymer clay, so just going to run that through the pasta roller a few times, just to ensure that it's both conditioned and nice and flat. And once I'm happy with that, I'm just going to go over with my acrylic roller to ensure that it's really nice and flat. And I'll use my trusty wet wipe to remove any tiny pieces of debris or airborne fibres, etc., that may have landed on my clay. And I'm just going to cut that into basically a rectangle shape for now, just with my blaze cutting tool, but you could of course use a scalpel if you prefer. So now what I need to do is basically try and work out what kind of size the clay needs to be. So as you'll see here, there's loads of excess clay. So I'm just going to start taking a little bit off at a time, basically. And this is still too large, so I need to take a little bit more off. So I've taken some more off and I just want to see how it's looking now. And apologies for the kind of weird angle, really. It's quite difficult to capture what I'm doing, but hopefully you'll get the gist. Just really trying to kind of measure up the dress, really. And I'm pretty happy with the sizing there. So what I need to do is just use my acrylic roller and flatten both of the sides. So my dress is of a good size and it's flat at both ends. So what I'm doing here is basically trying to stick the dress, and I'll do the back section first. And once that's in place, I can then work the kind of front ends like so. And once it's in a position that I'm happy with, I can then just start pressing the clay into the upper body. And you might find that you have bits basically coming out of the sides like I have here, so I'm just going to take that off with my scissors, like so. And I've got one of my Sculpey tools here that's got a flexible rubber ends. And what I'm doing is basically really trying to pull those pieces together. And I'll use my wet wipe here just to really try and flatten those edges. I wouldn't worry too much if you've got imperfections here, because hopefully once the groom's all done, you shouldn't notice too much. So the bride's basic body is all done, so I need to move on to her arms and her bouquet. So now I'm moving on to the bride's arms and bouquet. So I'm going to start with the arms, and I'm making them in a really simple design. Just going to roll out some clay and then just flatten the ends for her hands. And with my scalpel, I'll just take out a section just to separate the thumb from the kind of fingers area. So I'm going for kind of mitten looking hands, really, but you can get as detailed as you like, really. And moving on to the bouquet, I've got some green polymer clay and two shades of pink. And I'm making some very, very basic roses, but again, if you wanted to go for a more complex design on your flower, that's entirely up to you. And with a rectangle kind of shape, what I'm going to do is just take the end off so it's nice and thin at the ends, and then just curve that round like so. So I'll just make that a little thinner at the ends, and I'm going to need 7 of these. And moving on to the leaves, I've got a very tiny little cutout tool here, and I'm going to cut out 6 leaf shapes. So now I can construct my bouquet. So I just need to basically put 6 roses around the center rose. There we go. And just twirl that around in your fingers just so that the roses stick. I'll take the end off. And now I'll add the leaves, and they're basically just going between the roses like so. There we go. And to make it look a little neater once it's on the wedding cake topper, just going to add just a little length of white clay. Just take the end off. And it's entirely up to you, but you can also use some teeny tiny seed beads just for a little more kind of detail really on your bouquet. Just need to ensure that they're going to stick well in place really, so I'm pushing them down slightly with my tool here. And there we go, my bouquet is all done. So now I can start adding my elements to the cake topper. So I'm just going to add on the arms first of all. And obviously I need them to stick well, so I'm just using my fingers to blend in the clay like so. And sorry for the blurred image here, but I'm just using my medium-sized ball tool to really try and coax that clay together. So there we go, I'm pretty happy with that. So to ensure that the bouquet is going to stick well onto the cake topper, I've got some craft wire here. Just gonna pop it in like so, and I'll add some liquid Fimo. And I just need to ensure that it's not going to drop, so I'm just going to dab that with my finger. And now I can add on my bouquet. Just need to ensure that you press well on the bottom of the bouquet, just to ensure that it sticks. And once you're happy with the positioning, you can just mould the hands around like so. And if you wanted to add some shoulder detail to the dress, depending on the design that you're going for, you can of course do that. But I'm going to keep mine strapless, I think. So now I'm going to move on to the groom's body. And as a tip, if you're worried about neatness, you can always bake your topper before you move on to your groom. So I'm moving on to the groom's body, and I'm going to use some old clay first. So I've got a bag of old bits and bobs here, and I'm just going to roll that into a very basic kind of body shape really. I'll add just a couple of drops of liquid Fimo, and then just add the body like so. And then try and mould that into the base a little. And my groom needs a neck, so I've got just a kind of long conical shape here, similar to the bride's. And I'll pop some craft wire through like so. I'm giving my groom a white shirt, so with my tiny round fondant cutter here, I'm just going to cut out a very tiny segment basically, just so it fits around his neck a little better. And once I'm happy with the position, I'm just going to use my wet wipe here to really press that down. I'm giving my groom a tie in the same colour as the roses on the bouquet. So I'm just going to cut that into a tie shape and place that on. So now I'm moving on to the grey clay again. So I'm just going to run that through my pasta machine so it's nice and flat. And I'm going to make a waistcoat. So with the blunt edge of my blaze cutting tool here, I'm just creating a line like so. And with the sharp edge, I'm just going to create, well, a waistcoat shape really. So there we go. And I'll just position that onto the body. And again, once I'm happy with the position, I'm just going to use my wet wipe here just to really press it down into the sides. And I'll add on some teeny tiny buttons. And now I can move on to the groom's jacket. So I've got a length of the grey clay here and I've found it easier to curve the edges like so, just with my blaze cutting tool. And I'll just angle my tool at the top like so. And now I can add this to the topper. And to be honest, it will probably take a few attempts to get it to the right size, but this is basically the kind of size that you're looking for, really. And it's just a little awkward to position that, but I'm just taking my time. And once you're happy with the positioning, you can then just start pressing down so that the clay attaches well. So I'm going to make my groom some arms now. So I'm just going to roll out a length of clay like so and just take the tops off at an angle. And again, I'm just making some very basic hand shapes, but you can always go for way more detail if you prefer. So now I can attach my arms, and there's various ways to do this. If you do have enough room between your groom and bride, you could always link the arms, but mine's going to be too tight on this occasion, so I'm going to attach the groom's arm to the back of the bride's, and I'll just attach the other. So now I need to really try and pull that clay together. So I've got my medium-sized ball tool here, so I'm really trying to, you know, just coax that clay together really. So I'll just do it at the front as well. And if you're having a tough time trying to get your clay to come together, you can always add a tiny amount of Sculpey clay softener here to really try and pull that clay together basically. And I'm going to go in with my wet wipe now and really try and coax that like so. So of course my groom needs a collar on his shirt, so basically I've got some tiny segments of white clay here really to give the suggestion of a collar. And this is how I make the lapel, so it's basically just a length of the grey clay. And I'm just going to take the ends off at an angle. And you may well want to check this a few times on your topper, just so you get the length that you're happy with. So I've got the perfect size for my groom. So now I'm just going to make a couple of cutouts with my scalpel, so it looks a lot more like a lapel, basically. So now I can add that, and I just need to be mindful that the cutouts need to be parallel to each other basically. So now I can make a rose for my groom, just in the same way as before, really. And I believe this is called a boutonniere. And I'll add a couple of leaves. And I'm going to use a tiny bit of craft wire here, just to ensure that the rose stays in place. And I'll just pop that on. And my groom's body is all done, so now I can move on to bake. So I'm going to bake my topper for the second time. So I'm just using my mugs here again, and I'm using them really to offer just a teeny tiny bit of support. You'll see that the handle here is semi-supporting the bouquet in case it decides to fall a little during baking. And just as a point of interest really, you'll see that the mugs aren't actually touching the dress because I want to avoid any unwanted indentations really. So this is now off to the oven. And at this point, you'll need to refer to your own brand of polymer glaze baking instructions. So now we need to start creating faces, and this is where you can get super creative and really develop your own style. And it may well be helpful to spend some time with some paper and a pencil, really to try and nail your character design before you get started on your clay work. So I'm going to start with the gent's heads, and I've got a wet wipe here just to ensure that it's nice and clean before I get started. And this is obviously going to go directly onto the neck, so what I want to do is just to create a little hole. And by creating a recess like this, you'll avoid squashing your head too much really as you're putting it onto the neck. So I'll just use a drop of liquid Fimo to ensure that it sticks well after baking. And then just attach the head. So I'm going to press that down, and I'm really trying to ensure that I'm not making any indentations that obviously I don't want on his head. And I'm just going to mould that into a shape that I'm happy with. And again, I've got my wet wipe here just to remove any debris that I, of course, don't want on his face. And I've just done this exactly the same here with the bride's heads. So they're looking good. So I'm going to move on to some features now. And I just thought I'd mention that there's various ways that you can do your eyes. I've got some very sort of basic beads here, along with some eyes that I sourced, I think, from eBay. You can get these kinds of things from numerous places, maybe a haberdashery store, something like that. It's all about really trying to make your work unique and personal to you. So I'll just show you in brief how I put my faces together. But of course, this is something that you really want to experiment with and, you know, just go wild with, really. As artists, we should all be striving to make work that, you know, represents us as creatives, really. So I'd really encourage you to spend as much time as you can, really, just really trying to nail that specific character design that you're after. You don't have to go for a cartoon style, you know, you could go for something that's way more simplistic. Perhaps you want to go, you know, a bit surreal, or maybe you're interested in more figurative work. It's really worth spending the time to, you know, really explore what you want to do. And if you find that drawing doesn't particularly work for you in really trying to visualize what you want your creation to look like, I'd really recommend that you get some old clay outs just to really try and nail that aesthetic that you want to show in your work, really. So there we go, my little couple is all done and I'm pretty happy with them. So now they're off to the oven to be baked for the final time. So now I'm going to bake my topper for the final time, and I'm still just going to use a mug handle just to ensure that the bouquet is nice and secure while it's baking. And again, at this point, you'll need to refer to your own brand of polymer clay's baking instructions. And here they are, all done. And I don't know about you, but I think they look super cute. Also, I just thought I'd mention that once it's baked, Fimo polymer clay is non-toxic, so it can be placed on an actual wedding cake. Although if you're a little worried, you can always use a round segment of parchment paper to create a barrier. And once you're a little more experienced with wedding cake toppers, you can really start to develop your own style. These are some toppers that I made some years ago now, but I think it's really interesting to see the difference in styles and how you can play with aesthetics, really. Thank you for watching, and indeed a very well done for getting to the end of this tutorial. And I fully appreciate that there may be questions that you have as a result of taking part in this tutorial. So by all means, leave those down below. And once I get enough of them, I'll perhaps do an additional Q&A video at some point. And I may well go on actually to make some further videos on wedding cake toppers. And so I appreciate there's obviously an array of different like bouquet designs, etc. So yeah, I may well add to those at some point. And I just really hope that you go on to make your own wedding cake topper. And I would love to see the end results. So when you're ready and you're able to show images of the wedding cake topper, i.e. after the wedding, by all means tag me at Clay Disarray on basically any of the social networks. Pretty sure I'm at Clay Disarray on all of them. And yeah, I can't wait to see your results. So thanks for watching. Give it a like if you get this far, and yeah, see you again soon.